An exciting last day here. All three matches look very good. These teams have been battling hard. Long Beach played a very entertaining style. Hasn't been able to get in the win column, but one more chance to get out of here.
Both teams actually still looking for their first win of the showcase. McMaster started off the tournament on Sunday versus Ohio State and lost that match 3-1. And then yesterday they played Lewis and lost 3-0. Long Beach State started the showcase on Saturday against Trinity Western and lost 3-2 in a tight battle. And then last night lost to Alberta 3-0. And what was closer than what the score said? If this match is going to be anything like this first couple, these first couple points, we're in for a good match.
Nice job by both sides there. I love when these long rallies start early. So Long Beach cashing in early. Rivera loves to force the middle, and that was Anderson he went to. And nice back and forth with Mack there. That was Delegadis to finish it off there. And we'll take it there with Tyler Pavlik.
We'll see if there's quick turnaround time for Long Beach. They played the late match last night, which started at 7:30 last night, 7 o'clock, sorry, and would have finished around 8:30, and now they're back here for the first match at 11:30. It's a quick turnaround with it being New Year's Eve.
And with Nate Harlan being the only noticeable change with the lineup, it looks like the same guys, so you're right. Not a lot of rest last night for the boys. Ireland going for the angle there, can't find it. I've been entertained by this Long Beach squad. The bench likes to get involved a little bit. They're not afraid to have a little fun there.
There might be a little bit of rowing going on.
Here we go, Siegfried. Back to serve. Can't find it there. So we have seen this lineup a few times with Paslet playing on the outside. Obviously a very talented player. Really made a name for himself in the OUA as a right side, but showing he is skilled enough to play the other wing here.
And in that first match where we did see this lineup, Delegadis was just a monster. I think he went about 14 for 14 down the middle. He had a few errors later in the match and early in the match, but that middle part, he was near unstoppable.
Pavlik back to serve for Mack as we're all tied up at three. And that's what we've seen throughout the showcase with McMaster, just a great read blocking system. So anytime they can get the setter just off the net like that, middles with great footwork, great press there. I think we'll give credit to Ireland on that one for taking it, but Bennett Swan right there to help him close.
Bennett Swan was actually a little far off the net there. If it had to hit him, it might have come onto McMaster's side. It's a great athletic play by Delegadis.
Great shot by Ireland there, getting involved early.
And you see the difference between that first shot by Ireland, which hit out of bounds and tried to go off the middle blocker's outside hand, which is a very, very tough shot, versus that challenging the block high and seeing what's going to happen. If that lands back on McMaster's side, that's an easy recycle, and they're able to stay in rhythm.
And I'm hoping for the coaching staff stake at Mac that's not the trend here. That's McMaster's slight holiday break rust coming off, where every time they get something going, they find a way to miss a serve at the back. So hopefully
Absolutely.
We work out the kinks today.
Absolutely. That first match in four sets, they missed 22 serves. And last night they were approaching 20, or yesterday they were approaching 20 as well, too. In coaching and talking to some of the coaches, the best way to beat a team at volleyball is to make them to play volleyball. When you miss serves, it's difficult to play volleyball.
Nice job by Moody, the Long Beach middle there. Once again, Rivera loves to force the middles. They're going to be a threat in every situation here.
Oh, nice touch.
Great hustle play by Long Beach. They don't seem to allow any clean kills. Everything's contested. There's always going to be a battle, as we see Rivera running into the scorer's table there early on.
I'll tell you, Friday, I was able to catch Long Beach State's first training session here. They had some practices here. and they were doing a kind of a defensive drill with a guy kind of in five, kind of in six, and if someone didn't dive, there was a touch 10 drill that actually just popped up, and the players had to dive as the entire rest of the team did the laps around the gym. So Alan Knipp runs it very, very tight, and you can see why. Once a match comes around, someone's diving into the stands.
Siegfried has trouble with that one. Rivera well behind the attack line. Great dig by Briggs there. Lines person called it out. Did we get a touch on the way out?
Net violation.
Oh, okay, good eyes by you.
Yeah. It's one of the things with guys jumping from everywhere. You make that slight move to your left to try and get out to a close of a block, and then all of a sudden it's on your right, and you might have that little stutter where you get a little piece of the net.
That one sails long by Rivera.
A few serving lows to start this match. Hopefully we'll tighten up a little bit.
Craig Ireland back to serve, one of the fifth years here. We've mentioned it throughout the showcase, a guy who really waited his turn in this MAC system to get the number called and doing a great job now that he's kind of the guy on the outside for MAC this year.
And I really like this that first serve from Ireland. So Ireland has gone 110% on a lot of his serves to start to be here at this match. And he hasn't seen the ball go over, frankly, nearly as much as it's hit the net. That one was a 60% roll shot, saw the ball go over the net, and here he's able to go back a little bit more. And honestly, that is a closer miss than some of the misses he's had
Definitely. Throughout
the last 2 days. But to see the ball go over in your jump serve without needing to switch to your float serve, I think is a good thing. And I think he's going to have a better serving day because of it.
Pereira handles that one well for Mac.
Great dig.
Olivier, he's been shown that he can hit that sharp angle. This one sails at the side.
It's a great dig by Mason Briggs, just all the way through the ball. And you even noticed right after he dug it, he pops up just in case he has to play the ball again from the ground.
Hustle play by both sides there. Siegfried able to terminate for Long Beach. Good. It looks like McMaster's finally in rhythm. They've been battling, and now finally some serve defense kicking in for them, extending some rallies. I'm glad to see Pereira's kind of settled in because we know how good he is, but he just hasn't been able to showcase that yet.
Ooh. Colden.
Sure, Mark Moody would tell you that was in the whole way, but the MAC bench disagrees a little bit there.
And we talked about this in the first match a little bit. Paslin may give a little bit up on his passing. You mentioned that he was a right side for most of his career, an all-Canadian right side. But he's able to do that. Just hit out of it, hit over top and find a deep corner backdoor kind of shot. So he'll give that up just a little bit.
Siegfried mishandles that one as David Doty earns the ace for Mac. They extend it now to 12-9.
Long Beach State is the defending NCAA Division I champions. Had a little bit of turnover.
I say that mildly. Great job by Doty to reward Ireland with the dig there coming mm-hmm. through on the pipe.
And some of those, the dig where you make the dig in rhythm, it's almost the same as you passing the ball off of a serve and you're able to get your full approach in. I think Ireland actually likes that angle where the setter is a little bit behind him. It forces him to open up and see the court because that pipe set is pushed just a little bit, but it allows him to open almost like an attack from the left side.
And you mentioned that in the earlier match we did with McMaster. Even though Doty was pulled off the net there, the pipe just happens that much faster, right? Because he can just tee it off the top of his head as Ireland comes through. So nice to see them still have a threat even though he was well off the net. As we come into this timeout, we'd like to remind any viewers looking to continue their volleyball careers after graduation, you can get a top-notch graduate degree in the UK while playing volleyball at Northumbria University.
And for those of you just tuning in for the first time, we've had this up all week. Some of you may be tuning in on CBC and haven't watched any of our broadcasts. This really is a showcase of volleyball. It's the reason why we wanted to get it to a wide audience to be able to see just how good volleyball can be and showcase some of these really great North American teams.
Another ace by Doty, and he's going to force Long Beach to make a change here as Poole enters the game for Siegfried.
And the tournament is a little bit different. We're calling it a showcase because there is no finals. There is no final match. The goal of this for the teams is to play some really good matches against some international competition, while having a little bit of, we'll call it country pride. Right now, Canada is leading 5-4, but today's got three matches, so it could swing either way.
Great dig by Pereira, running the back row there for McMaster. Doty founds Delegatese.
Little bump quick.
Pavlik would like that one back. Little disconnect there. Good serving run by David Doty and the McMaster Marauders as they are up by 5 now. 10 serving 15 as Long Beach goes back.
Just a little bit late on it.
Wow, that was not happening on day one for McMaster, but they've been sticking with it and plugging away, and that's just a great job by Craig Harlan coming full speed ahead.
And it really begins with that pass. Pereira is able to pass that ball so that you've got four options offensively. We hope you're enjoying it so far. If you'd like to follow us on Instagram, Can-Am Volleyball. It's the last day. You'll get lots of updates, highlights, and really get a feel for what it's like in the building.
And this technical timeout is brought to you by First Point Volleyball Foundation, proudly growing boys and men's volleyball wherever they see a need. Nice as the showcase has kind of progressed. We saw early on day one and day two, both teams would try to kind of feel each other out. But now the coaching staffs have been able to get video. They got a little bit more of a plan. It's aggressive from 0-0 today, and it's nice to see a change from where we were at the start of the showcase.
Absolutely. The first 2 days, we saw unbelievable crowds, really. It being the weekend, Saturday and Sunday. Saturday was a sellout crowd, and Sunday was standing room only with 300 fans kind of standing around the upper mezzanine level. And they were treated to some really great volleyball. But now you're seeing, as you say, very much teams look like they are ready to get into their seasons or get into the second half of their season.
As a return, that's Matthew Paslett back to serve for McMaster. Unlucky coming out of the tech. 11 serving 16 here. Nice hybrid serve there by Poole. Pereira has a little trouble with that one. Ireland hits his way out of trouble, though.
I think Ireland was the sole starter yesterday, who played with a little bit more of the reserves yesterday. And I don't think offensively he had the game they would have liked, but it's interesting to see here. He's really bringing a few different shots. He's already got four kills since that first air that he hit just wide, but he's really attacking that block to see what he can do with it.
That's Pavlik there for McMaster, just not having the luck from the service line just yet.
And this may be something that they really need to focus on as they go through. They've got a couple float servers and a couple spin servers, and when their float servers do end up missing, it puts so much pressure on their spin servers to get that serve in the court.
And there we see Poole kind of handcuffed by the Delgadis attack there. Wasn't sure if it was in or out, and got an awkward touch on it. Mack will take it. They lead 18-12. And credit to McMaster's coaching staff for kind of sticking with the plan here. Obviously, they have the showcase here, but they also have two big exhibition games before their return to second semester. They were able to convince Trinity if they're going to come all the way to Toronto to play, they might as well come to Hamilton, too, and finish off the trip with two more exhibition games. Long Beach disagrees, but that one sails just out the side. Rivera putting a little slice on that one to try to get to area one.
Linesman wasn't sure quite at first. I stand corrected.
Once again, Ireland going for on his serve. I agree with you. I think he was managing his serve better on his first attempt last time back. We'll see how the match progresses, but that was his 110 attempt again and just not connecting. Pereira handles that one well.
Nice dig.
Great call by our officials there as that one doesn't find its way above the tape. Another hustle play for Long Beach as they earn this one.
Great dig by Rivera. A one-handed scoop to bring it to keep it alive. Yeah, all tape there. Great work by our camera crew.
And Poole under a little bit of the time crunch there as he came under to take care of that ball, and Rivera chose to set him on the tempo, just couldn't get his feet set.
And this is here where I'd really like to see if McMaster can use this as a training session. So last couple points, they've been a little bit out of system. Everything is running wonderfully when they pass the ball well. That pipe's active. They're able to get their middles involved. And they look just a little bit uncomfortable when it's out of system. And this might be a really great match for them to work on those out of system and stay a little bit more in the system.
As we see Rugosi check in for McMaster. He's done a great job coming in off the bench and just managing a tough spin serve. Yeah. Not an easy job for the first year.
Simultaneous substitutions.
Guinasso checks in for Long Beach. He was a serving sub a lot last evening, so a guy they trust a good, put in a tough serve, get a dig for the squad. Rivera letting Harlan know that on Long Beach we go get that ball, so letting the young first year know that that second guessing did it. Just go, run into the first row and get that ball.
Those are the expensive seats.
Doty, who had a nice service run for Mac last time back, sails one out of bounds. Gonna see another service sub by Long Beach. This will be Matt Johnson checking in for Olivier.
Yeah, Mac already was about six service errors.
Helps that they're siding out a little cleaner today. When they weren't, it starts to dig a hole a little bit. Not a bad run. They've established that they want to play out of the back row and have first tempo. So
set was a little behind, and Ireland had to kind of reach back to go get it.
Passo passes that one well. There's the connection that Tyler Pavlik's been looking for. Hasn't been lucky yet, but he got all of that one. Pereira letting him know with the little koala hug cheer there. That was good to see.
Koala libero hug. Just the back, the 60 slide. And you can see what they're trying to do here, right? So they've set that pipe more than they've set their front court middle. So that middle on Long Beach has to stay at home. And then they run the slide behind the little back 60, which opens up. And so what's kind of neat here is that actually the backcourt middle, as they try to own the middle of the court, is what's holding the middle more so than the front court.
Great shot by Delgadis. Yeah, just to pull on your point there, McMaster's been famous. They want to own the middle of the court. And when we had guys like Santoni or Demianenko, it was easy to kind of just run the middles over and over, where now a little bit younger in the middle with Pavlik being in his second year, you're right, they're still owning the middle, but it is coming from a back row attack this time.
and different styles of middles, right? You can have some of these middles are quite large, they're 6'8", 6'9", 6'10" middles, but they aren't quite as athletic as you'd say a Danny Demianko was, where you need to, it needs to be systematically in the right spot, and then they're going to move it around, whereas you kind of lay it up for a really strong athlete, and they're able to make some shots.
Yeah, I was on the wrong side of the net with Danny Demianko a few times growing up, and you just do a shot chart, and it turns into a fan by the end of the game, because the guy can hit every angle, every shot. He's just, what a special athlete.
Special athlete, very good person, yeah, absolutely. I was fortunate to be an assistant coach with the McMaster Marauder program from 2009 until 2014, and coach some of these special athletes.
As we come out of that timeout, we'd like to thank our friends at Icorn Tax for being proud supporters of the local volleyball community. Mac looking to close this one out as they lead 23-18. Great run by Long Beach Pool coming in over top of the middle there. Great speed by Rivera.
You know, they trapped a little bit there. You notice that that the left side ended up taking the middle blocker and they sent both out to the left side. Still a little bit late, so probably something that they really want to work on. My guess is that they're not seeing much of the C ball and they haven't seen much of it, and that's why they're able to trap in that rotation.
Just like that, Rivera's going to test the C ball. Olivier with the continue. Ireland just managing and taking what the set gave him there, finding a way to terminate.
Looks like they're really going at Rivera, I think, on the block there. They like that matchup, and Ireland versus Rivera.
Tom Williams is going to come in for a serve. Another guy who Dave Preston likes to call the number late in matches. He's been known to put in a tough serve and get a dig.
Oh.
Dottie thought about it, left that one go, and that'll be the first set as McMaster takes it 25-19 to open up the first game of our showcase today. Seeing both teams return to the court. Same lineups we've seen. It was interesting last night. Simone Anderson had a game for Long Beach, and they really ran him, even though he was in a tough matchup. Him and George Holborn going back and forth last night hasn't had as much an effect. It's Mark Moody, the other middle, leading the way with Long Beach in kills. And looking at McMaster, five kills by Ireland, five kills by Delegace. It's the wings who are really taking home for McMaster here. But the middle's running into some gaps, just kind of causing a little bit of disruption there. So everybody's an option with McMaster, but it is the wings kind of terminating everything. There we go, Delgadis starting it off here.
It's their ability to, McMaster's ability to side out right now, so that they've missed the same amount of serves that they have all tournament, but their ability to side out is what's allowing them to take a little more risk from the service line.
Harlan has trouble handling that one. They're going to give him a high ball here, hits a continue. There it is, Passlet. We were just talking on break. If they can find a way to get him going, McMaster is going to be very tough to beat in the second half of the OUA season. That one sails just out the side as Doty tries to go into area five again. Moody back to serve for Long Beach.
If you're just tuning in and this is your first time kind of watching collegiate volleyball or anything, the matches are best 3 out of 5. The first four sets are 225, and the final set is to 15. We've had multiple matches this week go to five sets and go to the distance.
Great shot of Ireland coming through the back row. Again, if you're not going to establish your front row middle, they're going to own the middle of the court through their back row presence with that fast pipe set.
And they've often run Paslin even more than they run Ireland from the backcourt, but it seems today that they're really working that connection with Ireland.
There it is, Anderson getting involved. So as I mentioned last night against Alberta, I thought he was the guy on Long Beach, and he kind of disappeared here in the first set. Rivera trying to get him going early. Or obviously credit to McMaster, they were watching the same game I was. So if you're going to plan for Long Beach, that's a guy you want to identify and try to find a way to stop.
Little floor maintenance.
Olivier back to serve for Long Beach.
It was great. That rolled into the net, rolled right back to him, caught it on one bounce, and rolled it over the ball person. It looked choreographed almost. As we mentioned, this Long Beach squad was the NCAA Division I champions last year and did have a lot of turnover to graduation. And I think this is a really great tournament for them to play some high-quality quality competition and see what they've got. The guys are going to be put in positions where they didn't play a lot last year. I believe Rivera was a serving sub last year coming in, and now he's kind of running the show.
Yeah, as I've said earlier, any team that loses TJ DeFalco, you're automatically going to go down in class, I think, a little bit. He's just such a special player and already a big part of the U.S. national team. Oh, well, it stays alive.
And a dump. What a great
what
point.
What a hustle play by McMaster as Paslin and Pereira go into the banners at the back there.
Add that to the highlight reel tonight.
Long Beach, a little question here of what Jason Dodd wanted to call
see
their
it
great
again.
Shot. Yeah.
One hit there and a one-handed ball back in into an attack. And I think they called a lift here, so a dump. I think they called a lift on the first ball.
Great shot of those OVAA and Volleyball Canada banners, proud partners of this event. Mack wanted that one. Sails just out of bounds. Anderson back to serve for Long Beach. What a pass by Pereira.
Oh, man.
Pass that coming out of the back for Mack. Olivier, that one sneaks through. Great transition dig for Long Beach there. That was a great shot by Paslik coming out of the back.
Yeah, it was a back pipe, which he spent so much time on the right side. He feels as comfortable on that back pipe as he would coming up straight through the middle.
Anderson goes into the 5-6 seam here. Paslik struggles with that one. We're all tied up at six.
This is great. Let's see if Long Beach can sustain some serving pressure and see if they can steal some points here or see if McMaster can actually respond and not rely on a missed serve.
Ireland overpass there. Moody chooses to recycle. Rivera takes it on two. So interesting choice by Moody to choose to recycle that one, but it pays off for Long Beach as they convert the point. Anderson earns another overpass for Long Beach, and that's Poole taking care of it. Dave Preston's going to call a timeout, trying to slow down Simone Anderson as he starts a run for Long Beach.
This is exactly what Long Beach needed to jumpstart and hopefully jumpstart their offense and their defense in a little bit of flow. And quite honestly, this is exactly what McMaster needs. They need to not be let off the hook here. They need to side out and actually pass this ball and run an offense. Whether it's a one pass, a two pass, and a hard attack, this is the type of serving that they don't see all that often consistently. Yes, there's guys in the OUA that serve just as hard as this once or twice, or guys on their team, and we've seen it today, that can serve it once or twice. But consistent three, four, five, six serves like this in a row is something they need to learn to be able to side out.
So the 8-6 Long Beach as we come out of this timeout, and we'd like to remind you to tune into our Instagram and YouTube channels at the end of each night to catch the Geniac plays of the day. Make the best plays both on the court and with your homes. Nice job by Anderson showing that he can blast it into one, and he's sniped a few into that 5-16. We'll see what he wants to do on this attempt.
I think each Marauder passer has had to pass one of these.
Throws a passlet here. Unlucky as Harlan had a play on that ball. Anderson kind of jumped over on the scissor there. Mack will take it down 7-8.
Good job by Paslin just to pass it, you know, a two pass to get it out in front of him and give the offense a chance.
Ireland going with the hurry up serve there, and he chooses to float. Nice adjustment by the fifth year Mack student. As we mentioned, he's going to spin serve most likely, but nice to see he's got a few tools there he can go to. Nice jump float.
Back to it again. Great dig.
Great spacing by Swan there. McMaster showing that they're going to attack a lot of gaps on offense here.
And they're moving the middle, front and backcourt middle around a lot. You can see Ireland going on that back pipe as well, and the amount of spacing that's there.
Moody adds to his kill count there as he terminates another one.
So as we mentioned earlier, McMaster's really great when they're in rhythm. When they get a free ball like that or able to pass it right to the net, I want to see if they can dig out of things and when they're not quite in rhythm.
We're seeing both sides of Dalgadice again, so he's been known to just take over in spurts, but also make a few errors from time to time, as we see one on the sea ball there. Great pass by Pereira.
Great block.
Unlucky by Poole there as he bangs one to the net.
That dig turned into a perfect high ball set. Goes off the arm. Didn't get much of an approach, but...
Moody with another kill there. Great job by the Long Beach middle. They're up 11-10 here. Poole back to serve. He's been going with the hybrid lately. It's been working well. Tough one for Long Beach as they do get the dig, but they're crawled on the net. Mack may have thought they got a touch there. I think that was all tape. So we have seen this from McMaster where the setter digs the ball. So that was Doty with the dig there. The six-pack player is actually coming through, and they have the choice to hit it or set it there. And Ireland chose, they say, that's a good dig. I'm going to take a cut on this. Confusion there by Long Beach. The hustle play doesn't pay off as he just can't get out of the way.
A little bit of scramble ball and we're all tied up at 12.
Good job by Ireland to get the tough dig as they ran Anderson in transition there.
Well, you see, we talk about middles in the front court fronting an attack on the defensive side when they're blocking, but you also like to do that in the backcourt as well too. That player in six being able to shift and slide. If they do run a 30, you're going to take a step to your right, slide, and take that shot right away so that if the middle blocker doesn't slide, that dead-on shot is yours.
Nice shot by Harlan as he gets involved. Long Beach still battling as they keep their lead, going up 13-12. Olivier hits one out the back as we're all tied up at 13.
There's a little more rhythm to the match. That's the first missed serve in a little while. A little more rhythm. And both teams needing to earn the points instead of trading off missed serves.
Mac block, just couldn't get pressed over there as Olivier blast one off it.
Get
a shot
here.
I'd be surprised if they reached over. Yep, still on their side of the net the whole way there. Great hustle play by Pereira.
Somehow. I think Ireland might have blocked that while still standing on the ground that second ball. He jumped with the middle and somehow it came down into his hands.
Cool, dealing with some tough sets there. This one just a little too tight. Sails a little bit on his jump as he catches the net on the way down. Nathan Delgadis back to serve for McMaster. And there's the Anderson we saw last night. So good to see him going in the second set as Rivera chooses to go to him.
Full read block and couldn't quite get there.
Having a game here.
Yeah, we're seeing a different Ireland. Just need to work off that turkey, I think.
Showing a variety of shots as he hits that one front row left side for Long Beach off Poole.
He's been the number one target. He's gotten more balls than likely almost everyone else combined, whether it's front or back court. And now he's starting to feel it a little bit.
Yes. Poole sneaks that one through.
Not sure if we'll see that one again, but I'm going to hazard a guess. It wasn't quite pressed over. They had three up. And again, all very little. The antenna is a nice marker to see. If you see hands on the other side of the antenna, then it's good. If not, it looked like it was pretty straight up and down.
So Ireland leading the way for McMaster. He's got eight. Delgadis has got six. And Passett's got four as the wings are leading the way for McMaster. Moody is leading with five at Long Beach. Anderson is up to three now. Olivier's got two. Long Beach going to need a little bit more production out of the left sides as they are a great scramble team, and it usually comes down to a high ball. So we'll see if Poole or Harlan can carry the load here.
So far, it's trading points back and forth. There hasn't been very many runs, which is the case in high-level volleyball. When you start to see, runs of 3, 4, 5 points on one team and then back the other side, it usually means that the level of volleyball has gone down a little bit. At this level, you should be able to handle most serves, be able to pass the ball well, and be able to side out. The advantage is on the receiving team, believe it or not, even with some of these cannons of serves. The advantage is on the receiving team because you get the first chance to attack.
Long Beach will serve out of this technical timeout. The technical timeout brought to you by First Point Volleyball Foundation, proudly growing boys and men's volleyball wherever they see a need. Little confusion here. Long Beach doesn't know what rotation they're in. They're going to have a quick check. And Rivera will go back to serve. Yeah.
Great dig. Go almost.
Harlan tried to strap that one on as Delgadice gets the best of him. Pereira having a game here.
He is.
Very steady for McMaster, showing what he can do. Guy who's got lots of international experience. He was with Canada on the FISU side. He's been on the junior national team. He's even gone to a beach world championship. Rugosi in to serve for McMaster.
It's a great serve to have off the bench.
Nice dig there by Mack. They try to force Pavlik on the 30 and can't connect.
And that's you'll notice, I'm not sure if we'll see a replay, but Doty was on the ground still, right? A lot of times when you're setting your setter or setting your middles, it's a good pass in your jump setting, and it just changes the timing. So you need to change your set just slightly, and it didn't actually change the set.
Ireland handles that cool serve really well. Nice job by Long Beach as they find an answer for Paslett. Olivier going to get credit with that block.
And that's a ball that should be recycled, right? That ball didn't go straight down. That wasn't on the hitter. Yes, it was a good, clean block on it, and it's up nice and high. That should be a recycled ball.
Another good pass by Ireland. Pavlik, once again, not getting the connection he wants, but being very effective when he does get his number called. Another kill by the young middle.
Don't think he got that at full extension, but having missed Doty, having overset him a couple times, I think they're trying to figure out that window for him.
Doty keeping with that float serve to area 5. Harlan battles that one off. Nice play by Long Beach as they go to Olivier. They take a late lead here, up 19-17. Guinasso is in to serve, so as we mentioned, we'll see him roughly once a set for Long Beach, a good serving sub. They extend now, Long Beach up 3, Max gonna call timeout. As you mentioned, good adjustment by Long Beach, just applying the right amount of service pressure, making Mack work for it a little bit more, disrupting that serve receive.
Yeah, they're passing about a 2.5. It's not a 3, it's not off the net, so they only have 2 options, but that connection needs to be closer to perfect for that middle connection, and they're trying to force it a little bit, but you're getting an error here and there, right? And that's all that it takes in a match this close, a 3-point lead, it's 1 point the other way, and it's only 1-point game, so to disrupt just a little bit, but the risk isn't really there with these serves, right? It's a consistent serve, but that allows their big spin servers, the big jump servers, to take a little bit more pressure, add a little bit more pressure.
Just looking over at the Long Beach timeout there, Coach Alan Knipe letting the staff take the timeout there. He pulled aside the 2 left sides, and he's just mentioning we're reaching too much on Delgadice on the right side here. Look to front here. It'll be passing on the right side first with Mack, but they don't want to reach out on him anymore. They want to try to front and make him hit through them as he finds a seam.
That's just nice and high, right? The block was a touch late, but I'm not sure if it would have fully mattered because of where he's contacting the ball.
Now he passed it back to serve. Mack trying to get something going here late. They're down 18-20. And another serving sub coming in for Long Beach, as Johnson will replace Olivier. Nice pass by Paslett. There it is, Delgadice using the block again, so Coach Alan Knipe just on the sideline there letting him know we got to make a small adjustment on that one.
If you are in the Toronto area, we do have 2 more matches. We have a match at 2 p.m. and a match at 4:30, and that will close out the Can-Am Holiday Showcase.
Tom Williams in to serve for McMaster.
A lot of it, Anderson taking a lot of attention there.
Bennett Swan turned to kind of apologize to the block there. I'm not sure he made the wrong choice, as he did have to respect Anderson on that play. Mm-hmm. Does bite on it, though, leaving the one-on-one for Harlan.
One on half.
And there's the adjustment Long Beach has been looking for. Poole not reaching out this time. A little bit more of a front. Presses over.
And that was, again, that two-and-a-half kind of area, and it's still trying to go rhythm right there. And so it looked a little disjointed because Doty went fast, and Delegatese might have been expecting a little bit higher to give him some shots and some mm-hmm. options to see the block. But it's that two-and-a-half pass that that Mac really hopefully will adapt to and work on through this second half of the season. Because when it's a three pass or a perfect pass, they're running on all cylinders. When it's a one pass, you know, they've got some great outside hitters to be able to put away some high balls. But are they staying in rhythm?
Definitely. As we see David Doty unable to pull that one out of the net. Master now trails 24-20. A little court maintenance as we get a good shot of the OVA sport court. Great job by the OVA to get involved in. So I think the sport court is a nice touch. You guys have great floors here at Toronto Pan Am, but sport court just makes it a little bit more viewer friendly, I think. Mm-hmm. Anderson going up the 5-6 seam, earns another overpass.
Yeah.
That one snuck through as Long Beach will take this one 25-20.
The 3-meter line, that things get a little bit dicey. They're not able to fully run their middle. That right side ball gets a little disjointed. They had some success a little bit earlier using their backcourt, and they completely went away from it late in that set. They started to go a little bit safer. They went to the guys that they wanted to finish.
There, we got a great shot of Coach Allen Knipe just making constant adjustments here, letting Olivier know we got to be more of a threat in transition, especially if our left side's going to come underneath. So just talking about a path he's going to take with Rivera here. Doty's been doing a nice job serving into five here, and this one's no exception. We'll take it there. Moody adding another kill. Long Beach really good at establishing their middles in all of the early sets here as we're 1-0 in the third here. The overpass. Ooh. Harlan catch him on the way out. No, that one sails long.
Allen Knight turns and pulls out a little bit of his hair.
Nice job by Pavlik to follow Anderson there.
But that play is going to pay some dividends. That play, that's a 2.5 set, able to still stay a connection, and Pavlik has to stay and respect that. Let's remember this play. I think that's going to pay some dividends, actually. It's a point for McMaster, but I think that's going to be really good for Long Beach.
That one sails out. Great job by Pasta. Those are two tough serves to start off this third set. Mac, again, finding just the right amount of service pressure. With another big slowdown there on Anderson. Anderson takes care of the overpass on that Pereira dig, though. Yeah, really impressed by Allen Knipe here, a guy who's won back-to-back NCAA championships. He was the U.S. men's national team coach. You see him on the sideline. He's taking this one seriously. He's invested, giving constant feedback to the guys.
Nice dump over, smart play.
Great choice by Rivera. Mm-hmm.
was a lot closer than it looks.
Yeah, definitely. I'm sure if we were to ask Craig Ireland, he knew that was out the whole way, but that one tailed in a little bit.
Way out, not even close.
Olivier going for the sideline there, can't find it. Good job by McMaster. Just enough serving pressure to get Rivera off the net again.
A little bit loose here, this set. I'd like to see it tighten up. We've had a few over bumps on digs, a couple, three or four errors now. So let's see if they can kind of hone in here and get back to that high quality volleyball that we had in the second set.
Harlan chooses with the off speed there. Mack able to dig it up, but Ireland unable to take care of that high ball from Haslett. Long Beach sends the triple.
Mm-hmm. Tried to challenge the middle blocker there on a triple. Generally not the best person to challenge on a high ball triple block.
Nice pass by Haslett. Doty showing some trust in Ireland, goes right back to him.
Interesting swing. He swung fast, right? He got his arm around fast as the block was still on its way up, so he was able to take it off the top of the block and at the back end.
Got another scramble play here by both sides.
Great play. Play. I'd like to see him be a little more aggressive on that.
Cool, doing all he can just to continue that one. Great choice.
Probably our point of the match so far.
Definitely.
A lot of defense, a lot of one arms, and a lot of touch over.
Just a great battle by both sides.
You get the referee kind of slow play timeout here. Unlucky.
Good eyes by the officials there to see the four here.
I think every McMaster person saw it as well, too, as they held 4-4-4. Just helping them out.
Trying to be sneaky there. Pereira gets to it. Dougherty's hits that one into the net. Maybe caught a piece of the block.
And Anderson's serve really was part of that difference maker in that second set. Let's see if he can put a lot of pressure on the McMaster serve receive here.
Yep. Nice job there, finding the baseline in the 1-6 seam there.
A little bit of an off speed. It caught the serve receive passers a little bit higher because the pace of the ball was a little less.
Anderson showing he can really locate with his spin serve. He's hit every location there is so far. Goes into one again. Mistake by Harlan.
It's a great shot.
Nice job by Olivier there.
That's a tough, tough shot hitting the C ball well off the net. The set coming from position one, so it's got to travel over your shoulder. And it's really tough to see the block there.
Anderson back to serve. Long Beach can erase the 4-point lead they McMaster just had over them early on in this third set. Nice job by Ireland to get them out of trouble. He's going to go back to serve for Mac. Better choice there to go high off the hands against the triple than to really
try and challenge
those inside seams.
Yeah. He does challenge that block. And when you challenge a block, every once in a while, they're going to get you.
Moody can't connect there. And Olivier heating up for Long Beach. Great shot. Nice dig by Mason Briggs there in six. Long Beach likes to play the libero in six. He's just going to play center field and roam on everything.
I'm really impressed by the Long Beach block here on that on the left side. They've made some really great adjustments, and although the one on Ireland they didn't get, they've now got two in a row, one on Paslin, one on Ireland, where that block is funneling it into six. And so they're not getting a block so that it goes down for a point, but it's maybe not a free ball, but it's a diggable ball that the player in six is able to recycle. We'll see if the attack can make an adjustment.
Foot fault there by Rivera. Bennett Swan is going to serve for McMaster.
And that's the point I'm talking about. Right there, another 2.5 pass, and Pavlik has to stay with the middle because they forced it there, which leads, you'll see him way over here, adjustment, doesn't get there at all, is still on the ground on that right side ball. And so, yes, they lost the point, the second point of the game, because they got blocked, but pays dividends here, and now you don't know what to do as a middle blocker. Do you have to stay, or do you have to go and go into a read block there?
Master challenges that one, but Harlan will get it. That's another kill. Just like that, Long Beach has tied it up at 10. They trailed 8-4 at one point here, but they've just been clawing back. As you mentioned, just kind of scripting some plays, setting things up. Rivera making great decisions.
It's really the serve receive of McMaster that's broken down right now. They haven't passed too many balls in front of the attack line here with the aggressive serves of Long Beach. And Long Beach's outside blocking is really good.
There we go. Long Beach takes the lead. We blast that pipe out of bounds.
I like that choice. First time that they've had a pass to the net. You would assume that they're probably going to commit a little bit on that middle, but you're still able to own a bit of the middle of the court by using your backcourt player. He just kind of sailed it.
Has trouble with that one. And Long Beach is on the net, so I will end that rally, but Poole was right there on the Delgadese C ball. Good job by Pasta to step in and still make a hitting attempt for Mac on that one. Dig by Poole. Harlan sneaks that one through on Delgadese. Long Beach up 12-11 now. Herrera handles that one well for Mac. Great outside block by Long Beach to turn that one in. Oop. And that one back pays off. So as you mentioned, Parrish, these outside blockers not trying to do too much, just really framing the court, making everything go back into six, and that one finally gets them the point. And Wojciech Krawcz is going to check in. So every match I've called for McMaster so far, he's coming off the bench and had an impact right away. Definitely making a case for himself to start in the second semester.
6'10", definitely a towering presence.
Pasa thought he got it, but nope, just long on the 5-6 seam shot. This rotation can be a little bit of trouble for McMaster because we've got Delgadese, who's a lefty out there in position four. Obviously, Pasa being a true right side, I should say, he's stacked in two, so he's everywhere he wants to be, but unable to connect on that one. To see Sam Cooper enter the game for Paslet. Cooper will get an attempt here. And caught a touch on the way out as Poole takes care of it on the pipe. Long Beach, good scramble player. Mm-hmm. Master searching for answers on a couple subs there. They're finally going to call timeout. They trail 15-11.
Yeah, Long Beach
just outlasting a little bit longer on these long scramble plays. The outside blocker is really making a difference. Nice adjustment by everybody involved.
Yeah, Mac playing Long Beach forcing McMaster to play out of system and winning that battle right now.
As we take a quick look at the stats here, Craig Ireland leading the way for McMaster with 11. Delgadice has 9. Passed it before being subbed out there. He had 5. On the Long Beach side, Moody and Poole both have 6. Olivier's leading the way with 8. Anderson's got 4. And Harlan's got 3. So Long Beach starting to spread it out a little bit. Olivier definitely having his best set so far. As he's been a threat both from the front row and the C ball for Long Beach. I think McMaster wanted a touch on that one, but no luck. Ireland sails that one out, so Long Beach takes us into the tech, 16-11.
I think that was more hope than
fact.
I don't think that one was very close.
And this technical timeout is brought to you by First Point Volleyball Foundation, proudly growing boys and men's volleyball wherever they see a need.
Let's see you again. I don't think
no,
so.
I think good job by Kraj, the Mac middle. Doty sending him to the other gap. I think they got the seam they wanted to run Ireland through, but couldn't find a home.
Yeah, it'll be interesting when they take this this back and look at efficiencies, how efficient that pipe was versus setting their middles and where they were most efficient. And we don't have a breakdown of efficiencies by set with us here on the broadcast, but as they look at what each set did, and they break it down by rotation as well, too, in each guy.
So Mac's been stuck in rotation one for a little bit here. Once again, Delgadice can get the job done from the left side. It's just a little bit trickier being a left-handed player out there. Pereira's going to give it to him. And there's that Long Beach block, getting McMaster out of system.
Yeah, they're really struggling to pass the ball now.
Great job by Moody applying service pressure, keeping them stuck in this rotation. Pereira challenged by that one. There's Kraj taking care of the overpass on the dig. Cooper doing all he can just to keep that one in bounds. Any nice continue. He'll go back to serve for McMaster.
Just wonderful serving pressure. Really great. It wasn't too overpowering, and he didn't change anything. He just stayed with what was working. Able to get one and two passes.
And there's Anderson for Long Beach. Nice first ball side out for Long Beach. They extend their lead 18-12.
Looks like Long Beach is really starting to find their rhythm now.
Nice pass by Ireland. Wojciech Kraj, first year from Poland. He's made a statement every time he's been subbed
absolutely.
In.
Absolutely. He's very empowered. Very assuming, so you forget that he's a freshman.
Great job there, leaving enough space. We did see him jam himself earlier in the showcase. Nice job by Long Beach to run their middles in transition. Anderson with another one. We saw a lot of that, not only last night, but in their first game against Trinity. Long Beach really enjoys getting their middles involved in every phase.
That's a little bit of Olivier, though. That he had a shot. It was a a little bit in rhythm, but the block was set, and he hit a nice high shot, so they recycled it almost as a free ball.
Cooper coming through on the pipe, trying to run him up the 1-6 seam. Nice serve by Harlan, putting McMaster in trouble. Great shot by Delgadis. Mack down 14, serving 20. Great shot there to challenge Poole on the outside hand. This has been a great showcase so far. I think we've seen every variation of a setter dump from a lot of people. Calling at Lewis doing a lot of great things. We see Rivera taking a turn. He had the tip to five earlier. Got the left-handed throw down there. Love seeing when setters can get involved. Ohio State setter was obviously very involved. He'd like to call his own number, so great seeing a lot of variations from these setters.
Great dig. Just a little too far. Making friends with the fans in the expensive seats.
I think if you're going to come to a showcase game when Long Beach is playing, you got to be alert at all times. They're coming at you. Ireland goes back to the spin serve on that one. Finds its way into the net.
He had some success with that float serve and decided to go back to the spin. Our next match should be a great one. Two undefeated teams in the showcase so far.
We'll see what the coaching staff wants to do, but I think if they both go with their starting lineups, that is the makings of the best match of the showcase so far. Mack able to keep that one alive.
It's a great set. Scrambled. A little bit of a scramble, and you'll notice on the Mack side that when things are a little bit out of system, it feels scrambly, right? And I think they just need to continue to put themselves in these types of situations where that feels less scrambly. That ball going into the block, coming down, there's a lot of jabs at the ball where if they do it time and time and time again, there'll be a little bit more control to it, and they'll create some system out of system.
And there we see Rigosi, the service sub for Mack. Unlucky on this one as he hits one out of the back, but as mentioned, he's been solid in that role. We'll see Long Beach. Siegfried's going to come back into the game. He's going to take out Harlan. So Siegfried started the match, returns here late in the third set. Poole back to serve, doing a great job with the hybrid. See if he wants to go with Ireland again or if he's going to test Cooper. Neither as we serve one into the net. Mack down 17-23.
Really impressed with Rivera. He's really just been calm, really got his middles involved, and that ball to the outside looks really good.
Harlan returns for Long Beach, so just a quick breather, maybe get some feedback from the coaches, and earns one right away. Long Beach middle, Moody will have a chance to close it out. They're up 24-17.
It's back in the rotation where they really struggled 6 ago.
Nice pass.
And a paintbrush.
Well, they all count. Nice shot by Kroj there. The off-speed, no way Long Beach could have a play on that one. We'll take it. McMaster down 18-24. And Cooper sails one at the back. Long Beach takes it down. They now lead 2-1 as they close it out 25-18. Coach Dave Preston going to keep with those subs he made. So Cooper and Kroj are going to get the start here as they try to get something going in the fourth set.
And what do you think the difference between that third set, which kind of slipped away? It was close at the beginning and kind of slipped away.
I think the Long Beach outside blockers have done a great job, and that's really disrupted the McMaster wings as they were dominant in the first set. They finally found an answer, and now that they've countered, McMaster hasn't been able to counter that play yet. So the cat and mouse game has kind of started right now.
Yep, the ball control of McMaster just dis- disappeared. So everything was a high ball, which at this level, it's going to be really difficult to score. And the serving pressure of Long Beach was just ideal. They didn't, their float servers put them in enough pressure and allowed their spin servers, and still, even the consistency was high.
Nice job by Moody with the tool at the side there. So McMaster already in that tough rotation here. They've been stuck a few times with Doty in one. Moody, the perfect guy for Long Beach to go back and just apply constant pressure.
They'll take it.
Unlucky. Mac gets out of that one early. Ireland back to serve. Had success with the float serve. We've seen him hit a couple good spins, most into the net or out. So what will he go with here? And serve, gets it. Nice job by Ireland.
It's a little more difficult than it needed to be. A little chicken wing dig.
Delgadice takes care of that one. Master an early lead of 3-1.
A tough shot off the net. Go straight down the line.
Good to see McMaster start this one ready for a fight. Love seeing more volleyball. Would love to see this one go to a fifth. Ireland takes that one in the net. Olivier is going back to serve for Long Beach.
And Delicate, he's 6'6". Not huge for a right side. I mean, to an average person on the street, yes, he's very large. But, you know, in this tournament, not a huge. But he is a good jumper. I think he's up in that 11-10 kind of range with his touch. So it opens up a fair amount for him.
Nice dig off the cross tip there. And Harlan hits that one out. So once again, Cross just unable to connect on a few balls here.
It's a difference of when he's a little too tight versus it doesn't give himself space to jump and to finish his swing, and when he stays off the net. It's kind of the case with most middle attackers.
It's in a tough serve here. Long Beach out of system. Cross with a nice dig there.
Middle dig.
And Cooper converts. Love seeing that. Love when the middles can get involved on defense.
And Cooper, a freshman at McMaster, set a record for the entire school for highest jump touch. So I believe it was 12'2" he touches.
High praise from not only a great volleyball program, but a great athletics program. So a lot of bragging rights over a lot of special athletes. Nice serve by Kraj, getting the setter off the net again. And Mack will take it, hits him on the way out. Yes.
Now you're seeing a little bit what Long Beach was able to do during the end of that set to McMaster, a nice consistent float serve going over and resulting in a two pass and a high ball offense, and allows them to set their block.
Long Beach choose to take the timeout. They don't want to let McMaster get away with this one early on.
Yep. And at any level, whether you're watching this and you are, you know, a 12U player and you're learning how to play volleyball, you're a 16U, the game is won and lost from the serving and passing. It is too difficult to consistently hit out of high ball situations in serve receive. You may have the best attacker, and you may be able to hit out of it once, twice, but you're going to get either a continue out of it or an error. And the numbers just say, when you pass the ball well, your offense and your ability to attack is just far stronger, far higher.
As we take a quick look at the stats here, Ireland with 12, Delgadice with 11. Next closest would be Passa with 5. And on the Long Beach side, Olivier's got 8. Moody's got 7. Anderson's got 6. Harlan chipping in with 4. Poole also has 6. So a little bit more balanced on the Long Beach side. McMaster really coming down to the wings and see what they can do. Kraj with another nice serve. Nice continue by Cooper. He chose to go on 2 there.
That doesn't happen very often.
Anderson, nice run in transition for Long Beach to get out of trouble. They trail by 3.
Anderson, just such a force in the middle.
Nice pass by by Pereira there. Ooh. What an angle by Poole there. I'm not sure if the block shifted a little bit too far over on that one. He's able to sneak it in. Really tried to seal line, and he's able to slice that one into the high 5-6 seam. Harlan sails that one out. Delgadis back to serve for McMaster.
It's too bad here. As we said, the last set, they really, really won that serving and passing game in Long Beach. I'd love to see if they can continue that sustained serving pressure.
Nice pickup by McMaster. Cooper blasted off Briggs there. McMaster showing up for this one, lead 8-4.
When they can serve out Anderson, it's a very good thing for the Marauders. See here, another two, a bit of a two pass.
And that one catches, and Long Beach gonna make a change here. Siegfried's gonna re-enter, and he's gonna take Harlan.
As we mentioned earlier, if you're catching this on CBC and this is your first time with collegiate volleyball, it is a best of five. Long Beach is up 2-1 over McMaster Marauders. If McMaster can win, then it'll force a fifth set. And that one will only go to 15. The other ones go to 25.
And that is back-to-back aces for Delgadis. Alan Knipe says, no way.
I thought that one was a little long as well, too, but...
That one a little bit more shallow. Keep it in for sure. Great job by David Doty on the one-on-one there.
Wow. And you can see, Max,
we'll
even
look at it here. Did he reach in?
Even on that two ball, you can see the middle still staying committed, a little bit late to get, and then left a one-on-one. I don't think that was the right. I don't think that was the same play.
Remember that happening. A little bit different there. Siegfried with a nice pass. They run him on the pipe and just out.
Ooh.
At first glance, I thought that one did catch. But
me too.
Maxine has a better view on it than I do.
That was a wonderfully designed play. The whole gym thought it was going to Anderson. That's too bad.
Bear gets involved. A hopeful tool out the side there. Long Beach finds their way out of trouble, but they do trail 5-13.
And just a little bit of sustained serving pressure. You don't expect two aces from your float server on a serving run, but sustained in getting the ball off the net.
Anderson has been a steady server for Long Beach. See if he can get it going. No, and Mac finds their way away from Anderson right off the bat on the first serve. They lead 14-5.
And we've really seen... now we've seen some runs. Now we've seen some teams, either team play well for an extended amount of time. And for these teams, this will be about how long can you play well? Can you play for one set? Can you play for two sets, three sets? And so that's really what this is about.
And Siegfried makes no mistake on that attempt coming through the pipe.
Back-to-back pipe sets.
He's shown he can be the guy who hits that. Long Beach has done a great job establishing their middles. It's good to see a left side coming through. Poole has hit a few. They didn't really run Harlan on too many pipe attempts. Nice pass by Ireland. And that's out by Delgadis. Cuts the lead to 7 here. Served by Rivera. So Mack in full control here as they lead 15-7, hoping to go into the tech off this Bennett Swan serve.
With the long tights and the armband, it looks like he's in a full different uniform almost.
What a shot by Olivier, great angle. And this is number four, Dawson Fugate. He's gonna go back and make his first serving attempt of the match.
Maybe their spin serving sub.
Cooper coming through on the pipe there. Mack takes it 16-8 as we go into the technical timeout. This one may be tough for Long Beach to come back from.
And as we've discussed a couple times, there's that pipe set when the setter's off the net, which happens just a little bit quicker.
This technical timeout is brought to you by First Point Volleyball Foundation, proudly growing boys and men's volleyball wherever they see a need. Long Beach has shown they can come back. They've erased a few large leads. I don't know as much as eight, though, but they've been adjusting every time. And when they have put McMaster under pressure, they seem to get them stuck there for a few points. So I wouldn't say this one's over just yet.
And some of it's about, first off, momentum. You want to build, if this is going to go to a fifth set, you want to be in a frame of mind where you can you feel a little bit more confident. But the other part that we don't always talk about is that you are setting up plays that will happen in the fifth set. You were setting up middle connections. You were setting up running 60s to open up a pipe. You can see now that Long Beach has started to run some pipe. Even if they lose this set, that is now in the minds of McMaster and may have to make blocking changes to combat that pipe set now. So even if a set is potentially not winnable, you can set things up for that next set so that it's in the minds of the defense.
Yeah, we'll see if they choose to run Fugate on the pipe. We haven't seen any attempts there, but early on with these left sides, Long Beach chose not to run it, but their middles are doing a great job. That one sails out by David Doty. And Manasso's going to check in a little earlier than usual. He's going to be a serving sub here for Long Beach. Interesting choice. He comes in for Moody, who has gone on a few service runs of his own.
It's a nice way. He missed one last time. No second chance.
Nice job by Ireland. We'll see if he can apply just enough pressure to eliminate the Anderson option here. Chooses to go with the float.
And a quick whistle.
Three times the chime here for Siegfried, and Kraj gets the best of him on that one. Great job by the McMaster blockers, Delgadis and Kraj. Challenging Siegfried on all three attempts there.
Interesting block mechanics there. It's almost a late slap at the ball by Kraj.
He likes to go high, but he doesn't go over.
Well off the net, yep. So again, we've said he is a freshman. There will be some really great things that he'll learn over the years at McMaster. That block move is just a little bit off the net.
It's a nice job by Ireland changing it up. He is going to go with the spin serve this time after two good float attempts. Another block by the McMaster Marauders.
All right, whatever he's doing, just keep doing it. See this way. Maybe he keeps his eyes up. But again, it's a late. It's not up and over. It's a late, and then arms go over late. So if the offense is a little bit faster, he's not going to be pressed with anything over the net.
That one's out the side. McMaster increases the lead 21-9. So Ireland's hit a float. He's hit a spin. He's gone back to the float. What's he going to do this time?
Underhand. Takes a little off and gets a...
Still puts them in trouble. Siegfried uses the hands, though. Yep. Long Beach dug themselves into a hole here. 10 serving 21. Olivier back. Nice high swing by Cooper. Siegfried tools the block, gets him on that one.
Yeah, at that height, he's going to start to learn what he can do up there. Instead of just blasting it at the top of that, at the top of the strongest part of the block, which turned essentially into a free ball, he's going to start to look for some angles once he really figures it out.
Doty forces the middle. Long Beach takes their turn forcing the middle.
Oh boy.
Siegfried, it looks like he was going to try to recycle off that triple block. They get the best of him. Mac able to terminate 22-11 now.
This has likely been their best blocking lineup in the front court there. Yeah, this late in a match, likely they're not going to come back, but it's what you can set up for this next set. So that when you're in the fifth set, when you're in this rotation again, McMaster thinks about what you're going to run. Is it a pipe or is it a seed?
Olivier finds a way through that one. McMaster, the secret sauce right now is the serving pressure they've been putting on. They've been able to eliminate the middle threat that Long Beach established early. And when it comes down to the wings, they're putting them under a lot of stress. I don't think Siegfried's had a one-on-one yet as he gets subbed out and Harlan returns. Nice run. Bennett Swan takes care of that. If McMaster could just find a little bit of consistency, because their A-plus game is real, real good. They just haven't been able to kind of ride the wave and see that for a whole match yet.
Yep.
Ireland going to take second ball. High ball to Cooper. Not an easy shot as he tools that one across the court out the one sideline. Mac now leads 24-12. Delgadice already has a few aces this set. Sidney tries to close it out. Ooh. Nice tough serve. Out of system for Long Beach.
Should be tight.
And fitting that McMaster would end this set with another block. Close it out 25-12.
Well, you are in luck. We are going to a fifth and final set.
As we mentioned, to kick this one off, both teams looking for their first win of the showcase. This will definitely influence the mood as we go into New Year's. What a battle we've seen so far. We'll see who can pull it out.
It'll be toasts of champagne or drying the eyes with it as well, too. One gets water, one gets champagne.
So a quick one here. First to 15, win by two. I don't really have a favorite. I'm just hoping to be entertained here and see who can solve the battle that's been the serve and pass for both teams here.
I have a massive bias. A couple of fans from Long Beach have made the trip. Nothing like coming from sunny California to Toronto in December.
Got a little bit of rain earlier, we got snow today, so they're experiencing it all. Cool returns for Long Beach. Harlan will be the other outside hitter, same lineup they've seen, and McMaster, since making those subs with Cooper and Kraj, are going to ride the wave, and they choose to let David Doty serve first, which is great because he is a tough server, but it does put them in trouble with rotation one right off the bat. And we're all set to get this one started, the fifth and final set. Cooper coming through, going to set a high ball to Ireland. Good dig by Olivier to keep that alive.
A little confusion.
And Ireland battles that one out the side for the point. McMaster takes the 1-0 lead.
I like that. There was a lot of recycling going on with purpose, right? Trying to get them off balance, get them into a high ball situation as well, too.
Jody with another tough serve at pool.
It's almost like the float serve for McMaster on Long Beach is proving to be more difficult than
Definitely.
Some of these spin serves. Add in the consistency that the risk is a little bit less, but it has been the float serves that have caused a little more trouble.
Now Ireland is up next if McMaster ever loses the ball. So here we go. We'll see what he chooses to do if he wants to go for the spin or the float. But I agree with you. Delegatese and Dottie have kind of been leading the way, and the middles for McMaster as well, hitting some tough floats. Rivera back to serve for Long Beach. That one sails long, 3-1 McMaster. As mentioned, Ireland has hit a variety of serves this match. I'd like to see him go with the float, but he knows better than anybody. We'll see which one he chooses to go with. And he's gonna spin it. Pays off. Anderson, nice shot, able to tool off the block out the 5 sideline. That'll be key for Long Beach to establish him early. As I mentioned, Alberta, he was a force to be reckoned with. Hasn't had the best match so far, but very steady player for Long Beach.
Could be a good matchup because this is different. This might be the first time that you've seen Krej kind of against him.
Nice pass by Ireland. And Krej answers. We got a little back and forth between the middles here.
I like that. You have two physical middles going at each other. They ran Anderson right at him with the 50, which is his best set to hit. And they kind of go away here with the 30, which may open up Ireland on that pipe coming through.
Nice float served by Krej. And Anderson answers here. So both teams force in the middle. Cooper can't handle that one. Try to hit a continue.
Oh, simultaneous. So what happened here is there's a simultaneous fault. At the exact same time, the ball hit the antenna. Someone was a net infraction, and then both officials blew the whistle at the same time, and therefore it's a reserve.
I think that's the right call. Long Beach really wanted that one as they do trail 4-2, but right call by the officiating crew here.
Same time. You can see it on the replay, the exact same time.
Good tough serve. Rivera able to cut that one off, but Long Beach has to give the free ball. I think Long Beach thought maybe David Doty touched that one twice. Doesn't matter as Mack makes the hitting error. Anderson back to serve.
And that there, I don't know if they need to stay in rhythm. You've got a guy that's much, much higher and swings well on a high ball opportunity.
Handles that one well. They forced the speed to the Delegatese. He was only able to tip it, but does make the smart choice during the point.
The teams will switch sides when the first team reaches 8.
Nice pass by Poole. Arlen with the roll shot, pancake dig. And Cooper, unlucky, blasts that one into the net.
It's a really tough shot to be jumping backwards and try to put a full swing on that. Most of the time, that's either going to end up in the net like it did there, or 4 feet out of bounds.
Johnson's going to be subbed in to serve here. We have seen him earlier in the match. He's going to take out Olivier. Johnson, one of the many service subs Long Beach chooses to use.
Got a few on that bench.
Challenges Cooper. We get a touch on the way out. Yes, we did. McMaster earns that one. Cooper's going to serve for McMaster. Olivier checks back in for Long Beach. Poole can't handle that one. Long Beach in a bit of a scramble. Rivera going to hit a continue. Oh! Get called on the net. Rivera says, wasn't me, but Jason Dodd disagrees.
It's quite the set from the baseline. We can see it here. His head did hit the net on the land. I don't know if the ball had hit the floor first, though. We'll call that a Canada call.
Cooper, another tough serve, getting Long Beach behind the attack line setting. Oh. Can't handle that dig, though. McMaster under a little bit of pressure to side out here, see if they can go up 8-5 on the side change, or if Long Beach can close the gap before we switch sides.
I'm interested to hear to see if Cooper responds with a pass. So you just made a little bit of a defensive error. Can you respond, or is it compounded errors? They don't go at him.
And that's a handing error from Delgadis. 6 serving 7. See if Harlan challenges Pereira again. If he goes at the young Cooper. There it is, challenges Cooper. Little out of system for McMaster. Chest dig.
Ooh, almost.
Break
almost.
Stepped in there.
Angle that into that back corner.
McMaster earns the side change up 8-6.
As expected, when the team serves well, gets them out of system, they earn a point or two. It's good. The serving pressure has been good, not a lot of errors. And it's really going to come down to the outsides. The outsides, if they can score on a two-man block right now and not make the error versus have to give up a continue, if the other team can come and hit back it. I think McMaster has too many people on the court.
And we'll see it right now. Rogosi is going to come in as the service sub for Bennett Swan. Not the easiest of roles, especially for a first year, but Rogosi's done a good job as the serving sub over the course of the showcase. Nice job getting Long Beach out of system.
Great shot. And that there is case in point of the, we talked about a little bit earlier, and the crash doesn't quite go over until right at the end, and it's almost like a slap at the ball, and that slap's just a little bit late, and that's why that ball kind of went up and out of bounds. What you want to do is if you're over the net, if you're higher than the net, that part should go over. You really want to press right over.
Especially against these outsides for Long Beach, who've been known to challenge the block in all of their matches during the showcase.
Ooh.
Unlucky there. Grimasso struggles with that one.
Off of the kick dig.
Master earning a scramble point there. Nice job. They're up 9-7.
And that's remnants of Saturday on 14-13. A pass went up to the center and slipped through both of his hands to end the match. So.
Doty with another tough serve into area 5.
It's a good run. Great run.
Maybe a nice shot there.
Right, we said each team is going to try and get you out of system with their pass or with their serve, and then it's going to be the high ball attack of who can score and who is going to make the error.
Now McMaster has had a little trouble here in rotation 1. See how early they can get out of it. Rivera choosing to go with the float. Challenges Cooper. And that's a first ball side out for McMaster. Ireland gets it. Take the lead 10-8. Now Ireland has been going with the spin serve and the float serve. Majority spin though.
It was successful last time with the spin serve, so I imagine.
Unsuccessful on that one. Long Beach chance to tie as they go back to serve 9-10. It'll be Poole who's been hitting the hybrid all match. Raj on the 30. That seems to be the ball he has the most success with. Good job spacing off the net.
Yeah, he takes a long route. his feet get there really early, but that big arm takes a little bit longer to get around, and I think that's probably why the 30 works for him, because there's a little bit more time for the ball to get to him.
That's Harlan squeezing one through the block there. Anderson back to serve. He sparked a run earlier in this match for Long Beach. Good spin serve to either seam.
And this will be a very important side out for the team. This could make or break the entire match if they can get out of this early or if they can steal a bunch of points.
Great job by Ireland to battle that one off. And Harlan gets the best of Delgadice there. This has been a matchup Coach Alan Knipe has been giving a lot of feedback on. He's really spotlighted these McMaster outsides, especially the right sides, as we'll see Haslett sub in for Delgadice. Earlier on, we saw the Long Beach blockers reaching a little bit too far outside their body on Delgadice. The good adjustment there to front him and just press inside the court.
And Paslin back on the right here.
Ireland can't handle that one. Prayer is going to have to chase that one.
Wow. What a set.
Wow.
That was almost off the court.
Good job by Prayer going well into center field to find that one, and Paslett just...
Would have liked to see Paslett to get a little bit more outside the court to be able to see both that and the block, and he would have maybe been able to swing on it, but decided to go with the tip and make it happen.
Great dig by Ireland off Moody. Mac unable to control. Good run by Long Beach to keep Moody involved. He's been a key player for them this match. As we see the game ball going to the Long Beach bench there, having some fun with it.
Yeah, win or lose, both. This will be a great match for both teams to be able to get under their belt and play a close match. In which
one's out of bounds. They're asking for a touch. I don't think so.
I don't think so.
Good job by Long Beach to adjust there, finding an answer for the Ireland pipe.
Yeah, and what you want to see in a match like this is that the team earns the point, right? Scoring points off errors, that's not good high-quality volleyball, right? It's putting yourself in a position, that high ball set, and yes, it just missed, but to be a really good competitive team, at 12-12, you need to score that point if you want to be the type of team that you want to be.
I'd like to remind any viewers looking to continue their volleyball careers after graduation, you can get a top-notch graduate degree in the UK while playing volleyball at Northumbria University. So Ireland leading the way for Mac with 16 kills. Delgadice did just get subbed out, but he had 13 on the way out. Sharing the load on Long Beach. Olivier's got 11. Poole's got 8. Anderson's got 8. Moody's got 7. See Olivier back to serve for Long Beach, choosing to go with the float on this one. Prayer handles it well. Underset Swan, just a touch there. Pass that can't handle that C ball from Olivier as that ends up on the track here. Long Beach now up 14-12. So there's that constant service pressure they've been able to find the secret sauce with. Choosing to go with a float down the stretch. Ireland handles that one. Haslett answers after being unable to handle that dig. Answers on the C ball.
And this should be Cooper back to serve, who has a big cannon of a serve, but isn't always the most consistent. So we'll see if he takes a little bit off here to give his defense a chance or goes at it like he did the last few times.
Little bit off it, I'd say, and it doesn't pay off as that one sails out the back. Long Beach closes it out. 15-13 for their first win of the showcase.